Welcome back to World of Warcraft, Wrath of the Lich King, Classic Blind, episode 700. Back where it all began here, figured we could go over a bit of a recap before heading off to our next adventures. Way back in the beginning. Back in October 2019, we started here doing what we've been doing. Did some quests, went other places, missed completely obvious things for hundreds of episodes, got into some dungeons, got into a whole bunch of places all over the map. And then, around level 49, the Burning Crusade came out. So, a lot of people were definitely ahead of us, continued on to that before we were ready. So we finished up getting to level 58, probably was, with some interesting changes to the vanilla game. Some non-elites, various changes that we are still looking at in our current situation. Got over to Outland, did a bunch of quests over there, some dungeons, some more quests. Got through a good two-thirds-ish of that. Eventually hit max level of 70. Did more dungeons, did some heroic dungeons. And eventually, Karazhan, towards the end of that. Did not get very much further than that. And then, Wrath of the Lich King launched. We were on the boat, first boat over to Northrend. Did a bunch of stuff out there. All the quests, all the dungeons, and eventually all the dungeons in Titan Rune Beta, which was quite a bit more. Then we kind of started going back towards the earlier content, finishing every quest we could possibly do, except for a few outliers. Made it back through all of Northrend and Outland, and now we are back in the Eastern Kingdoms, just chilling, doing all the quests we can find. Started over in Stormwind, Northshire, did a bunch of stuff there, and then everything basically to the south here. Still have a few raid-ish quests here and in Stormwind. But now that we are down with the southern tip here, we are moving on up. Starting here, back at the start. And all of that took quite some time here. Total time played 34 days and 22 hours. Let me just pop open a calculator here. That's a lot of days. 34 times 24 plus 22. Well, basically it's plus 23, so 839 hours to get to this point. We've been everywhere. Got all sorts of fun achievements. Got lots of quests done. 2,549. So, getting closer to this. Definitely gonna get this done before we get Lore Master. Because Kalimdor and Eastern Kingdoms here, still quite a few left. Definitely making progress towards Lore Master of Eastern Kingdoms. 535 out of 700. Kalimdor is a lot more we need to do. Did not do a huge amount over in Kalimdor previously. And so, we start from the start here. Unlike over in Northshire Abbey, we've actually completed all the quests in the starting zone here. So we move on up forwards. There's also Brewfest going on, but I'm going to get to that when we get to that. We also have this entire pile of things from Zolgarub last two episodes. So we have to deal with all that, too. Make our way through here. It's like, oh, I'm surprised this counts as outside for the mount. Nope, just let us fly around, run around for that much time. Bold. Bold raider there. Do some speedy tactics here. And we are out. And we're out of combat, too. Run stuff. Heading out of the starting zone. And into the next section here. Where we have a few quests happening. We will go this way. Whether or not these were quests that were always here is a good question. Hard to say. There have been a few changes over the expansions to even the earlier zones here. So we will see. One thing that's probably new, or probably maybe not new, would be these quests here. Wild that there's a level 55 quest in Karanos here. That's okay. We will see what that's about. We also have a few over this way, which we'll go deal with. Let's just start here, shall we? With Ragnar Thunderbreath. Hurley Blackbreath. The Dark Iron Dwarves, led by the villain Hurley Blackbreath, stole one of the Thunderbrew's best recipes, Thunderbrew Lager. The villains. They don't deserve such a fine brew. McErickson, I have a tough task for you. Go to the Blackrock Depths in the Burning Steppes, destroy any kegs of Thunderbrew Lager you find, and bring back our recipe for Thunderbrew Lager. Please get that recipe back, even if you have to turn Blackrock Depths upside down to do it. We will be going to Blackrock Depths in the future. This is Dungeon 55. So we will take that. We even get some of the lager as a reward.
Keep your feet on the ground.
And one other quest right over here. It's probably going to be down inside here with this gnome. Ozzy Togglevolt.
Pleased to meet you.
No name. No main. No name. No gain. Since the accident, all Norman thinks about, or talks about, is cleansing Normagon of the Trog infestation and finding a cure for the sickness that plagues it, Eric Erickson. Luckily, Razzle and I are close to some kind of cure. Either that or the recipe for a really powerful rum. We won't know until we test. Naturally, in order to test our theory, we're going to need a few things. Namely, fallout from the irradiated trogs in Normagon. Fill up this file with green glow and bring it back. So that's a quest to go to Normagon.
Daylight's burning.
We should be able to blitz through that fairly easily. And it is nearby, so we can definitely do that. Possibly after a few other things here. Maybe we go and do these two here first. It's gonna be up this way, essentially. Just take the path here. And then we can loop back, get up to Ironforge, and do some very necessary banking and trading and stuff. Because we got just a pile of things that we need to deal with. I did put some of the things from Zolgarub in the bank for safekeeping slash later use. This is the stuff that needs to be more just dealt with, honestly. But we will get to that when we get to that. By the looks of things, we've got two more quests to do out here in Dunmoreau. One up here at the Ambersteel Ranch, and the other at the Golblar Quarry. Definitely been to these areas before. We'll see what they've got going on here. Hopefully nothing to buy another mount, because I already did that. Urdra Ambersteel.
Hi.
Protecting the herd. Gotta protect the rams, clearly. We heard the cries in the middle of the night. Then this morning, sure enough, the herd was missing two rams. The dastardly beast, known as Vagash, has been preying on our livelihood. With most of King Magni's army off in distant lands, fighting with the Alliance, there's no one to keep Vagash at bay. Perhaps you are brave enough to seek out the beast and slay him. Be one of his fangs and I'll reward you. Vagash lurks just above the ranch here, but be warned, he is deadly.
Off with ya.
Just above the ranch here, you say. Alright. Well, let's see where just above the ranch would be. We got some mountains and stuff here. Caves? Questionable. Let's see if we can climb any of these mountains here. Just above, they say. Up here. Seems to be working. Oh, there's a cave. Oh, we even got the remains of the rams here. What are we looking at? Oh, there he is.
I'm out of range.
He has 200 health. Eh. Just a little overkill. There's his fang. We did it! Yeah, not what you want. Just a guy just right above there. I mean, you got enough guys, you could probably have dealt with that yourself. Anyways, still terrorizes the herd. Please help us by killing the wretched beast. Here's the fang. Ta-da! Very well done. Vern will be so happy when he hears the good news. To kill Vagash is no easy task. I imagine one day he'll be fighting alongside King Magni's men on the Alliance front. Yep. Maybe one day. He will take your hammer.
Watch your back.
Green hammer. Not bad. Amazing. More parkour, huh? Looks like it's probably gonna be a little bit easier. Not as good with the mounted parkour. On the barrel. On the lantern. There we go. Much easier than escaping last episode. Fantastic. One more thing to do over here. Over down into the quarry. Did quite a bit down in the quarry over here. Back at the very, very beginning. Any of those tree boars lying around? Stuck in the tree, having a great time? Could be. Anyways. Down into the quarry here. I can't imagine we would have missed just one quest in here.
Hi.
So, potentially this had been changed. Or had a requirement somewhere else, somehow. As a member of the Senate and the Explorers League, I've taken it upon myself to take care of this part of the Trogimo Station that has gripped our lands. They've certainly made a mess of Golbar Quarry, and for no reason. Dug deep into the earth, they poured out, destroying our equipment and driving the miners out. Not much for us to do, but to exterminate the lot of them. Rebuild and get back to work. Then the Trars, I'll gladly recompense you for your time. 10 Rockjaw Bone Snappers. And that's it.
Safe travel.
It definitely feels like a quest we've done before. This does definitely feel like it's a potential thing we already did. So, bone snappers, huh? These are all skull thumpers. That's no good. Useless. Useless for the quest. Skull thumpers. I'm gonna sprint in here. Dead skull thumper. And they're just all... Here's the bone snappers. They're kind of dead. Just our luck. Or maybe they are, we're already dead.
Whoop. Need more rage.
Bone snapper. These guys. Where's a chest in here? I'll take a chest in here. Bop. Chest from down below. Not in line of sight, huh? Oh. Still chest. We're in combat. Didn't like us trying to grab their chest there. Some light leather. A fine scimitar. Totally worth 100 gold. Clearly. A fine blade indeed. Oh yeah. Not bad. A little bit less impressive than our weapons we have, but still. It's level 6. So, can't be too surprised. What else? Get out of here. Let's mine this copper. Why not? Just a little bit. Just a little bit of mining. We've done plenty of mining. And all of the other skills here. Those are all maxed. Having a good time. Get out of here. Whether or not this apparently refreshing quest will continue to count for multiple completions, or if it's like a separate quest that's just the same, they just changed it slightly so it counts as a new one. Hard to say. Anything could happen out here. Bunch of weirdness. All over the place, basically. We have dealt with that. Melissa wants us to go back in the cave and fight some slightly stronger boss-like guy. Which is also entirely possible. That'd be very on-brand here.
Great to meet you.
It's a start. Hopefully we can take advantage of it. Move some mountaineers in to secure the area. Then we can begin to restore our infrastructure and get the miners back to work. Thank you for your assistance. Okay.
See you soon.
There you go. We did it. Hop over to Ironforge. Technically we could get there slightly faster if we just teleported. Get the Hearthstone over to Dalaran and then just take the portal. We might want that later here. I can worry about that just yet. Keep the Nomergon here. And follow that for right now. Gesture's radioactive fallout. One shot, one fill. Already did quite a few quests in Nomergon, so this could be the last one. Either way, I don't think Nomergon's gonna be difficult at all. 27? I think we got that under control. I mean, we had a raid under control, so I don't think any of the dungeons are going to pose any threat whatsoever. Unless they have some interesting mechanics. Or I suppose even just mechanics that literally require more people. I can't think of too many things that have been like that, but it's always a possibility. If you ever get into situations where you need multiple stuns or anything, that can get difficult. Let's get all of our banking and stuff taken care of. There's a whole thing out here. That's going to be for Brewfest also. Thinking that's going to be next episode here. That's probably a good plan. For right now, got a few more things to do here. And also a few more things to do in Ironforge. So we also have some quests here. So we can check that out. A good number of quests on the tracker still. Lots of other locations to go to. Ooh, we got it. Having a great time over there. One thing here. Might want to get disenchanted. This one here. Did have these boots here, which we also could have disenchanted. I put these on for a potential boot for the intro. Unfortunately, it was not a good-looking boot. Much too fancy. So instead I bought the Tarnished Chain boots from the armor vendor nearby at the beginning. So that is now untradeable. Anyways, let's sell some things here. Sell this light leather. Post it. Sell this one copper we found. Three, I guess. This illusion dust. It's got a little bit of value. Seems low. I'm fine with that. 1-1. I'll take whatever I can get here, honestly. Still some solderite. Or probably not. That's vendor price. That's okay. Lots of things we can try to sell here. Like some bat eyes. Not much market. Some of these. Pretty nice. 5 gold each. Probably not much market. Never know. Move it all. This one has one in here. It's cheaper. Some mana potions. Not very many at all. Soulbound. There's an aquamarine. Decent number of those on the market. Sell that. Got some powerful mojo. Unlikely. Powerful mojo. Yeah, stacking 20 of that too. Wild. Still some rune cloth. Big old pile of that. Don't really need rune cloth. Some other healing potions. A bit low. Yeah, it's alright. Just looks basically vendor price. That is wildly expensive for an arcane crystal. Don't have high hopes for a lot of these. There's an essence of undeath. There you go. These ones are basically worth as much as selling. Some fancy bat leather. Unlikely to sell. Whole pile of these that we picked up. Doubtful. A massive mojo. There you go. Refreshing spring water? No. That's soulbound. These are basically vendor price. These can't be auctioned. We'll keep the thorium ore at least. That should be good for now. Go to a shop here. Get some stuff out of the inventory here. That'll be good. That'll be good. Sell some things. We don't need hammer. This. Cheaper rocks. These that apparently aren't any market for these. Reasonable vendor price too. So I'll take it. These. Clown feet. Scepter smiting. All these kind of greens and blues that we got. And can't sell any of these either. They don't want them. They can't be auctioned. Pretty much these are only useful for trading in. But we can't even use any of these. We already have the gloves we get for this. And we are not a paladin hunter or mage, so. Have to delete these. As they literally don't do anything for us. For you. All that effort to go to a raid. We're just here years later just throwing them away. Does make things work slightly better when you got 20 people trying to get the things instead of two. Don't get quite as many duplicates that way. Here's all of our other things from there. Got some of the coins. We got the wrist I was talking about. The other one. And there's still a belt that we could possibly get. Got some fish. The idol and the doll, which are also used. And the warblade and manslayer, just fancy stuff. Cool enough to hang on to for now. One thing I did find was the Zandalar honor tokens that we got for turning in a bunch of stuff.
Watch your back.
We can just use these to increase reputation. It's a little bit slow, it seems. This is going to help quite a bit with the reputation here. Should get us a bit closer. One thing we might want to do is get some more reputation items before we head back there later. Just to make sure we get to, I think it was revered we needed. So that'll be something to consider. Did have a check earlier, and it looked like there was some of the bijus on the market. A little bit expensive, but getting all the reputation, or all the reputation from the entire raid, and then also half of all of the drops that can be traded in for reputation, does equate to quite a significant chunk. So, only need to do like the second time when we go back and do all the quests we missed the first time. And a few more bits. Should get us to where we need to be. These are giving 50 each. And turning in the bijus was 75. So it's like 125 per. They look to be around 10 gold each. So a bit expensive, but we can't really expect too many to be on the market. Definitely a challenge to get some of the early reputations here. Especially with how some of them work. Would not be our first buy a whole bunch of things for reputation situations. That's okay. Honor tokens. Honor tokens. Not gonna quite get to honor here. Decently, though. Especially since we started from neutral. Definitely a good quantity of reputation gained. There you go.
Talk to me.
There'll be more stuff for the next time there. Okay. Wait, all the ores and stuff we're just hanging on to for right now. That'll be good. Let's check the mailbox here. I got a few things. And a few things sold. Let's take these. Cash stack is doing decent. 2,150 gold. Not bad. Just sell all this stuff to the shop. It's been through the auction house and failed, so. not worth worrying about, essentially. Let us go and deal with this. Because why not? I just sprinted through some dungeons. We'll see how sprint throughable it is. Probably gonna be, yes, very. At least gonna be slightly less than dead mines. More like key cards and all that. Different things you actually need to do. Really popping off at Brewfest here. Definitely going to be on the list of things to do. Having a great time. We're hearing them from all the way over there, huh? A little bit interesting with the audio there. Who expects the Dark Iron Dwarves? Says the Dark Iron Dwarf. That's fair. Let us head over here. I don't think there's any Dark Iron Dwarves. Might be. Very possible. We have dungeon quests and repeatable quests over here. I guess that is two dungeon quests. Grand Quest of Ring, a fine mess. I can grab some of those too. See what they entail. Just gonna be go do some stuff in the dungeon. We should be fine. Need an intervention. No one can. I mean, I have intercept. Since this is prevented at all costs. Next time for sure. As a dwarf, it does pay me to be avoiding Brewfest. But we will get there. And we will absolutely be there. It's gonna be a whole time. It's gonna be a whole thing. For now, no, we're gone. Captures radioactive fallout. I think this is gonna be a use kind of situation, or if it's just gonna happen. Past the leper gnomes here. This whole mess over here. It's a problem. It's a problem. This occasion will give you recent advantage. That's it. Not a party yet, just yet. Where's these quests? Outside or inside? These ones. Stop attacking. I don't think it's an actual quest here. Probably more of a it's in the dungeon kind of situation. Let's get down here. Fine mess. More sparkle mag action. And grime encrusted ring. Yeah. I'm surprised we can actually. So close to escaping. Yeah, don't. Get down here. There's a big thingy here. There we go. Oh, they're just going for it. Gnomergon. I think this is already completed on our list of quests to complete. Or dungeons. Two dungeons here. Is classic Dungeon Master. Yep, it's already checked off. So that's good. I'll be looking for actual quests in here somehow. Okay, we'll see. Here's the train depot. This is out of range. I need to get to. Oh, this guy here. Looks right. Empty file. There you go. That'll work. If you're on a way to remove the ground from the encrusted ring, so we need to find some kind of ring somewhere. And escort a clockwork Second of the clockwork run, the road to Scooty and Booty Bay. Okay. There's definitely still stuff in here. Let's see what we can do. Let's run through the dungeon. Should work out fine. Whoop. And then, whoop. Painted in Vader blood sprays into the air. Don't love that for us. Casting a radiation bolt. Not ideal. They're all dead. And we go. Let's see if we can see anything in here. For the quests. Whoop. I'm just gonna run around. Have a good time. There's a quest down below. That makes sense. How do we get down there? Probably going around. There's many ways in No More Gone here. That goes to the middle. Let's see for sure that's actually meant to go downwards. Is there. Looks fun though. Looks like a great place to be. Possibly drop down onto something. Okay, big, big old gear here. Looks very safe. Good place to be. There's a box of assorted parts. What kind of parts are we talking? Got some coarse blasting powder. And a chest. Well, that's worth enough for coming over to this section. Very fun. Got a dagger. Nice. What do you think? Jump onto this? Well, he's going for it. Just took a bit of damage there. No worries. No worries. Just falling down. Having a good time. Take even more fall damage. Still perfectly fine. Let's see if we can find... There's a quest was over there. That looks like it was back up. Mysterious. We got irradiated horrors all over the place here. Vicious fallout. Not me. He's dead. Acidic walkers. Thank you. Okay. We've set to some loot. Yeah. Uncommon. Something like that. There it is. Some boots. That's fun. I'm just almost seeing quest markers around the signs here. We'll see if we can figure out where those are at. There is no dungeon maps for this point. Here's somebody. Here's something. Such props. Grab encrusted object. Here is Kenobi.
Talk to me.
Kenobi groans. What happened? Last thing I remember was being captured by a group of dark iron dwarves. Aha, so there might be something here. Beat into with an inch of my life, and then thrown in here with these filthy trogs. Get me out of here, Eric Erickson. Here's the plan. Lead me to the exit. If we make it out alive, you go to Booty Bay, let Scooty know that I went to Ratchet to warn Tinkerwiz of the Dark Iron's involvement in the making of that super rig. Let's get going.
Glad I could help.
Escort quest. Let's do it. Yeah, let's get out of here. Jesus. Are we following? Looks like it might be a following. Oh my gosh, there's a bomb here. Is that his? Hopefully. Unfortunately, with him around, we're probably not going to be able to just sprint out of here. You'll probably get attacked by things. Let's even find an exit here. I mean, here's some guys. This is a clean zone. Here is the Sparkle-matic. Repeatable. Is that good? That kind of is being out of here? Perhaps not. What's this do? Alright, 5200 is empty. May a grime encrusted object to clean. 3 silver coins to start. Sparkle 5200 comes to life, lurching to and fro. Sighed the helpless grime that was encrusted on the object placed within is being pulverized by the machine's gnomish cleaning agent. Sparkle-matic of 5200 comes to a halt, heralded by a familiar ding. Armor receptacle of the machine sprawls open, revealing a newly wrapped box. This quest requires a fine amount of gold. You sure you want to continue? 3 silver. Yeah, that's fine. Right click to open. We got a coal. I mean, that's decent. We got multiple Sparkle-matics here. That's fine. So all we have left is finding this grime-encrusted ring. Presumably the grime-encrusted ring would go to the grime cleaners here. That'd make the most sense. Let's see if we can get him out of here. Does anyone want to go to, like, the entrance? Jones. Escort into the Clockwork Run exit. I don't know exactly where that is. It's probably fine. Clockwork Runners. So this is the Hall of Gears. So. This seems Clockwork-y. Quite close. That guy here. Definitely a slightly different escort quest. Where it's less of... I see the exit. Hurry, hurry. Anti-escape camera measures activated. Self-destruct in T-minus 20 seconds. Are you just following us around? Don't explode. Alarma bomb. Maybe it's not his. Maybe for... escorting me. Word of your deal will not go unnoticed. There you go. We did it. Were you inside or the outside? There's still some kind of ring in here. Just a... grime... frosted... ring to find now. Presumably, I actually have to find the ring. Probably here somewhere. Could be a drop. Hard to say. Doesn't specifically say anything. We need to remove the grime from the encrusted ring. Yep. That's the one. Well, the dwarves have such a thing then. Potentially. Not the trogs, probably not the robots. Could be. Let's make our way through here. Got a few other ways we can go. Kind of loops around there. Would be great to have the maps in here, but we can kind of work with the mini-map at least. Let's continue down. Many different directions to go here. Whee! Anybody else in here doing anything? Just kind of chilling. They're just sleeping. Doing fine. An engineering supplies trader there. And even a mailbox. Wild stuff. Alright. Let's keep going around. Go a different direction here. There's a machine in Punchgraph 3005B. We need to figure out any of these punch cards. It's gonna be complicated. I'm trying to look at the map that doesn't exist. Let's see if we find these dark iron gnomes. Or dark iron dwarfs, actually. That should lead us on a good path here. Defender. We're doing fine. Sprint past these guys. All them. He's having a good time. Okay. Die, foul invader. Yeah. Not gonna do that. Let's get to over here. Yeah. This middle section here looks promising. Yeah, they're beating on us. Not a huge deal. Intruder alert, huh? Yeah, it's fine. Here is Intruder 6000.
You like it? Just it.
Are you Rangers? Let's deal with all these guys. Got a million guys to beat up. They're dead. Where's your lag nut? I've set this slightly different. I guess it's because it's on. Here's the workshop key. I already have one of those. And a food crate. Delicious watermelons. I'm going to enjoy a watermelon here. Tasty. Okay, nullifier. Going that way. Oh boy. Trying to land. I mean, parachute. Here's an idea. Boom. Intercept for the drop down. Good stuff. Okay. Here's a Dark Iron Angel. A brown crusted object. Let's get through this section here. Boop. Boop. Let's see if we can find what we're looking for in here. Two different paths we could take. Everybody's dead. Cornbread. Could be a specific guy we're looking for in here too. They're dead. These guys. Come on. Very good. Seems a bunch of random stuff. Check all the dwarves, perhaps. Dark Iron Agent. Sash. Gonna grab from everybody. If we could move and pick up loot at the same time, that'd be also great. That's okay. Okay, Agent there. He's dead. Here's the final chamber. Looks like a good time. There's a They're more gnomy kinds of guys.
Usurpers! Gomergon is mine!
And then, I guess we don't need the key cards a second time. That's convenient. Charged gear of the gorilla. And a pet bombling engineering. Don't meet the requirements to loot that item. Just have to make a pet bombling. Hey. Pet somatic gear. I can't loot. Few. One, two. I go to him. Not sure exactly how that works. In here? Yeah, whatever. See if that actually works here since we didn't take it. Pet bombling. Fancy. How fun. How fun. Didn't have that one, since he looks like he actually used it, so. Good stuff. Good stuff. So that was the final chamber. That's alright. Map. Map. What are you doing? Die. On another section here. Got some leather, another object. There we go. Grime encrusted ring. Begins a quest. We uncover what appears to be a ring from the corpse of one of the Dark Iron Dwarves. It's difficult to tell what kind of ring it is. Over dirt and hardened residue, cake the item completely, making wearing it impossible. You think you can make out the slight luster of precious metal, maybe even the glint of a gem under the residue. If you want to make use of this ring, you're going to need to find something to get the hardened residue off of it. Figure out a way. I think we can do that. We know exactly where we need to go for that. Over to the cleaner things. So, that works nicely. Let's see if we can't get back over there. It's kind of a dead end here. Wild. Going around. Around and around. Still trying to look at the map. Let's see here. Another path this way. Looks like it goes back down towards the south. That'll work. Let's do it. Lots of paths and tunnels and stuff here. Definitely more of the older, more interesting interconnected dungeon layout kind of situation. That's nice. Engineering labs. All these guys. Beat that guy up. Evade. Unfortunate. Yeah, that does it when you get into a place where you can't be. Oh, these guys. They're dead. Yeah, definitely not putting up much of a fight. Engineering labs. Hey, look. Ooh, great. More watermelons. Can never have too many watermelons. Bap. Operating boots. Gnome bots. Good, good, good. Just kind of making our way around here. No one will be left behind. Yeah, I don't know how well reclaiming Nomragon's really gonna be going. I mean, well, I guess we'll find out. So we have the information flask here. That'll at least get us some way towards something. There's a bunch of guys. Not too worried about it. It shouldn't be. This way. Line of sight. I reckon in this room. Pretty good. So many paths. So many paths. These guys. It's bad. Oh boy. Diamond crystal. All these machines were for a different quest we already completed first time we were here. Sounds good. Expansive dungeon for sure. For sure. This way.
Too far away.
And you. Wait, get in here. Get back up to there. And I'll be just right. Complete the quest with this one in particular. Same level of Sparklematic. Should be fine. Rhyme Encrusted Ring. The most contraption before you bears a plaque calling it the Sparklematic 5200. The gist of the machine from reading the instructions below the plaque is to scrub away dirt that an item might have. She has a coin slot, accepting 3 silver coins to start the process. Was items placed inside it? It seems, though, the Grime Encrusted Ring you found earlier is just the thing to try in this machine. Get rid of all the grime. Place the ring inside the Sparklematic 5200. Deposit a silver coin into the slot. Painful grinding noises emanate from the machine as it begins to jerk around violently. One can only guess what is happening with the ring inside the machine. The machine suddenly stops, trumpeting the station with a simple ding. A receptacle opens up to reveal a small box neatly wrapped with a red bow, where the Sparklematic 5200 also gift wraps. Only the quest costs 3 silver. Yeah, it's fine. Guys are coming in here. Out of here. It's going. Return of the Ring. Opening the box produced by the Sparklematic 5200 is what you had suspected, a shiny ring. Wearing the ring, you feel magic power surge through your body. Inside the band is a small but nonetheless discernible imprint of the seal of Ironforge. Next to that, 3 small initials engraved TDK. They signify either the initials of the previous owner, perhaps the initials of the ring's crafter. Keep the ring, or return to this person. Decisions, decisions. You either keep the ring, or you may find the person responsible for the imprint engravings on the inside of the band. Entry. Sparklematic 5700 is now empty. May a grand crested object to clean and 3 silver stone. I mean, we have 7 of them. I say we go for it. As long as it just keeps on costing. That seems to be. Let's go for it. As long as it just keeps on costing 3 silver here. 2. Yeah, let's just clean everything here. Let's see what we get. We're getting presents. But we're paying for them, so. It's a whole system. It's a whole system. It just makes it all shiny. It's a great time. Okay. Let's see what we get here. We get Nomragon Band of Stamina. Okay. We get a Lesser Moonstone, a Silver Ore, a Copper Ore, Coarse Stone, Shadow Gem, and an Iron Ore. I mean, is it really gambling if every single thing is better than how much you paid for it? Here's a brilliant gold ring. And we have Return of the Ring. There's a quest there. Okay. Let us get out of here. Matchwork. Hop back over through Ironforge. Go turn in the vial here to finish off. Should be probably someone in Ironforge that has the ring. And we don't need it, so we can complete a quest by turning it in. And we might even get a different reward. So, all sorts of options out here. All sorts of stuff. Our ram is just heading out by himself. Yeah. Right. Iron Forge. This is gonna be the perfect spot to be, also. Okay. Turn the ring. There it is. There's like a fancy guy here in the Mystic Ward. Mystic Ward's a good, reasonable spot for where you would bring a magical ring. He's got stamina and spirit. That's what he got from the junk. Is more stamina. Rush Del Castle.
Salutations.
Hello. Hear about fee collection and/or summons. Must have mistaken me for someone else. Terribly sorry. Turn the ring. You. Hey, easy there, partner. I'm a very important businessman. I'm sure that the courier is just simply late with the delivery of the rent. Wait, you're not my landlord. Well, of course you aren't. Silly me. You come to me seeking the finest jeweler in all of Ironforge. One who does not make cursed items. Yes. What do you need? Got this ring for you. It's very shiny.
Off and away.
A ring, you say? Let's see. Yep, I made that ring, by golly. Before Nomergon went up, I had a small shop there. Perhaps it's one I left behind when I ran for the hills. It's a simple design. I make several like it. Maybe it's from someone who didn't make it out. Dark Iron Dwarves had this? Well, that puts a new layer of conspiracy on the 9 different layers already floating about. Maybe the authorities would like to know. It's wasted on the likes of me. Now back to the ring.
You have a great day now.
Gnome improvement. Listen, Eric Erickson. The ring is yours, sure. But I can make you a better one. That design, like I said, is really simple. I am a lot more skilled now, and for the mere fee of 30 silver coins, I'll spruce it up for you. Well, a little more than 30, actually. I'm in a tight spot right now. All of my material stock is all dried up. If you bring me a bar of silver and a moss agate, I'll add a silver and agate lattice to the ring that will give it a little more pizzazz. Trust me. Silver bar, moss agate, and 30 silver coins. To improve the ring. Basically, it's just paying for a quest completion, so we'll do that. We may even have. I mean, we've got a silver ore here. Pretty much, we just need the moss agate. Should be able to accomplish that. Head through the middle here. So we can do silver. Yep, we can totally do silver. Let's get that done. Totally doable. The moss agate might be slightly expensive. I suppose we'll find out. I guess we're losing money by making this silver, but that's also assuming it actually sells and buys for the prices they say they are. Anyways. Beautiful sex. Moss agates. We probably had these for our mining adventures. Personal mole machine right there. We're not keeping the gems though currently, so. I'd like to go shopping for a moss. Agate. Oh, very expensive. Very cool. One stack of two? I'll take a stack of one. Yay! Basically paying for a quest completion at this stage. As not ideal as that really is here. There you go. Turn this in. So we go from 4 stamina, 4 spirit. And we spend a whole pile of money to complete this quest. Make it slightly better. And then we're just gonna sell the ring anyways. We're definitely kind of getting into the just do all the quests mode here. No matter how ridiculous.
Be seeing you.
Now the materials I need, wouldn't ask you for them if I wasn't in town on my luck. Silver bar is also a bit valuable. There you go.
Right.
Ah, exactly what I needed. Someday, when I find myself out of this hole that I am unjustly in, I will make for you, for everyone, the finest trinkets in all of Azeroth. Till then, thanks for being a sport about the reagents. I normally charge 10 times what I've charged you for a ring of this quality. So, you frings, here's your new one. 9 stamina, 4 spirit. And crossbow.
Have a great day there you now. Go.
And some blue ring. Very nice. Okay. Let us wrap things up here. And wrapping up the Nomragon situation. Going in. Turning in this. So we could technically sell some things here too. But we're gonna be back to Ironforge. Starting next episode anyways, so. This'll be fine. That's just gold ring. Vendors for 64 silver. So, only lost a ton of money on that. That's alright. We can get at least some money from all the other shenanigans that we pick up. That's all good. That's all good. See if the mess here is solvable. Science point two, probably not. We'll find out. Back over near Kyranos here. And with this turned in, that is Dunmoreau completed here. The rest of it is the event and then also actually Ironforge quests. That's fair.
Interesting.
You see, we're trying to cure an entire species of gnomes here. We need more of the green glow. There you go.
Off and away.
Excellent work. The time has come to test the new formula. This works, not only should that captured leper gnome be cured, but should have a full head of hair. Stand back. What? Oh, there's the captured leper gnome.
Daylight's burning.
Only cure is more green glow. Not only was your sample insufficient in quantity, it was also impure. It requires more green glow. The trunks are obviously not irradiated sufficiently to fulfill our needs. You have to go into Nomragon and bring back some radioactive fallout straight from the tap. Speaking of the irradiated slimes, lurkers, and horrors, be warned, the contamination of this type of fallout is difficult. We need to make several attempts with the file until the suitable sample is recovered. Travel to Nomragon and bring back high-potency radioactive fallout. The fall is unstable and will collapse rather quickly. So also require your emulating collection file when the task is complete.
You have a great day now.
That's wildly inconvenient, going back to Nomragon. Maybe we start over there. Down in the dungeon. That will have to wait for next time. Goodbye.